So the next topic in Module 2 is classic problem synchronization, where classic problem synchronization, we have three problem solutions called bounded buffer solution, reader-writer problem solution, and Daniel philosopher problem solution. In bounded buffer problem solution, there will be three semaphores used to read the problem, to read the buffer from the producer, if producer produces the data to the buffer, and the consumer has to consume the data from the buffer, where each producer and consumer is using same shared bounded buffer. To solve this, there is n buffer size which can hold one item. One buffer can hold one item, and there are three semaphores: mutex, where it is initialized to 1, full is a semaphore where it is initialized to 0, and empty is initialized to n. So if you consider producer problem, once the producer need to access or need to write the data to the bounded buffer, can produce an item in next produced, then it has to wait for empty, stating that if wait for empty states that if the bounded buffer is already read by the consumer, then wait will be empty and the return value of wait will be empty, and wait for the mutex. Initially the mutex value will be 1. If the writer reads the data from the buffer, then it becomes 0. Once these two conditions are false, then bounded buffer will be written by the producer for by next produced data. Once producer writes the data to the bounded buffer, signal mutex and signal full will be given, so that the consumer is notified that bounded buffer is completely written by the producer. If you come towards the consumer process, wait for full, unless until the bounded buffer states or the semaphores of bounded buffer states it is full and the mutex value is initialized, this consumer is not allowed to consume the next data. Once it is notified with full and mutex value is released by the producer, then consumer will start removing data from the bounded buffer. Once complete data from the bounded buffer is read by the consumer, it will signal the mutex stating bounded buffer is released by consumer, and signals empty states that bounded buffer is consumed completely or bounded buffer data is empty. Producer can write the data to the bounded buffer. Second problem is reader-writer problem. So in reader-writer problem, we have a situation where data set is shared by reader, n number of readers, and a writer. In the reader-writer problem, reader only reads the data which is not modifying any data. So n number of readers can be given with permission to read the data, and since writer changes the data in the data set, writers only one writer is allowed at a time to read and write the data. So for this solution, we have again three semaphores: read-write mutex, mutex and read count. Read-write mutex is initially given with 1, mutex is initialized with 1, and read count is initialized with 0. So in consumer problem, in reader-writer problem, for the writer process, wait for read-write mutex, stating that if read-write mutex value from 1 is initialized to 0, then some writer is holding that mutex. If the read-write mutex is given back to 1, then writer can initialize the data set and writing is performed. Signal read-write mutex back from 0, the read-write mutex will be signaled back to 1, so that next writer will be allowed to write the data. In reader-writer problem, next process is writer process. So unless reader-writer problem, many readers can read the data at once. So wait for the mutex, since check the process or the data set which is used by writer or not. If it is not used by any writer, then read count is increased to 1. If read count equal to 1, then wait read count mutex. Wait for reader-writer mutex. Signal the mutex where there is no any read-write function is happening. Since it is only reader problem, reading is performed and read-write, there is no need for any other reader to read, but there should be a writer waiting unless all the readers remove the mutex. So signal the mutex. Mutex will be signal. Another reader can be reading the data, but the rewrite mutex will be waiting because no other writers is allowed to modify the data. Wait for the mutex. Read count minus minus. Reader count will be reduced if reader count is equal to 0. In the sense there is no any other readers reading the data, then signal rewrite mutex. If the read count is 0, in the sense if there is no any readers in using the data set, then reader writer mutex will be released or signaled back, and mutex will be signaled so that any writer can utilize the data set for writing. Next problem is Dining-Philosopher problem. In Dining-Philosopher problem, we have a problem of limited number of chopsticks. So here the condition is there will be 5 chairs in the dining table allocated for the philosophers, like 5 philosophers. 5 rice plates is given for them, but the problem is instead of 10 chopsticks, only 5 chopsticks is given in the dining table. This is our problem. To solve this problem, in dining philosopher problem algorithm, only 4 philosophers is given chance to sit at a time, and while picking up the fork, only allow odd number of philosophers to pick first left chopsticks and then right if odd number of philosophers is picking the chopsticks. If at all even number of philosophers are picking the chopstick first, then allow them to pick right chopstick and then left. Since odd number of philosophers have already picked the left chopstick, then for the even number, the right chopstick will be the left chopstick of them, and they cannot take the chopstick. So instead of holding one chopstick at everyone, either even number of philosophers will be having the rice and odd number of philosophers will be in thinking state or waiting state. If even number of philosophers will be having rice, then odd number of philosophers will be using the wait state or thinking state. This is how Dining-Philosopher problem is